Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, folks. Abdullah Mu'taz here. Inshallah, today I am going to be talking about a common misconception that goes around or is being spread about the hadith critics. So essentially, this misconception or misunderstanding or false claim is that these hadith critics, early hadith critics, the muhaddithun, they were theological bigots whose only goal was to forward their theological agenda and spread what they consider to be orthodoxy. And as such, they either forged a hadith themselves or they overlooked a hadith that were being forged to support their theological opinions. Now, this claim could not be further from the truth, as we will come to see today in this video. And in order to disprove this, there's many ways we can go about disproving this, and the easiest way and clearest way we can go about to disprove this is to show that we have many a hadith here that are found in the books of early hadith criticism which directly and expressly support the theological biases and theological leanings of these early hadith critics. Yet we find that these early hadith critics regard these ahadith as baseless or weak, even though they may agree with the end result of it, with the content of it, thereby showing that their theological biases did not hinder their ability to objectively grade a hadith. Now, let's go over some examples of this. For one, we have a hadith. It says, "Every nation has their majus, and the majus of my ummah, of my nation, is the Qadariya." The Qadariya are a heretical sect who used to hold heretical beliefs about Qadar. Now, Abu Hatim al-Razi talked about this hadith, and he said, this hadith is baseless. Now, Abu Hatim al-Razi is against the Qadariya. The Qadariya are his theological opponents. And we know Abu Hatim al-Razi's theology or theological opinions on this issue because he dictated him, and Abu Zura'a dictated a aqidah text, a theological text, to Ibn Abi Hatim, which is popularly known as Aqidat al-Raziyain, in which he discussed or clarified his own theological opinion about Qadr. So we know for a fact that he's against the Qadariya, and he considers the Qadariya to be a heretical sect, and they are his theological opponents. Yet, with this hadith here, every nation has its own majus, and the majus of my nation is the Qadariya, he says this hadith is baseless. We have yet another hadith, which says two groups who have no claim to Islam. It's essentially this hadith is making takfir of two heretical groups. It says, two groups whom have no claim to Islam, the Murji'a and the Qadariya. Now, Yahya ibn Ma'in, who is opposed to the Murji'a, and as Abbas al-Duri reports from him, explicitly going against them, he still considers this hadith to be objectionable, a munkar hadith, a hadith that may not be accepted, a hadith that is misattributed to the Prophet. Yet, as we stated before, this hadith does support his theological biases, yet he is still rejecting it. Similarly, we have another hadith that says the rhetoric of the Qadariya is kufr. And Abu Zura al-Razi commented on it, saying, it is baseless in my opinion. Now, similarly, with as we mentioned before with Abu Hatim al-Razi, Abu Zura also clarified his a theological opinion on the issue of Qadr in what became known as Aqidat al-Raziyain. In the book, he clarified that the Qadariya are his theological opponents, and he clarified his actual beliefs on Qadr. Yet, he still considers this hadith to be baseless, even though it is in support, in actual direct support, of his theological biases. Now, there are many other ahadith that can be shown. These are just three examples. We have ahadith that, for example, are of the virtues of Umar, or of the virtues of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. And we know that Abu Hatim al-Razi, Yahya ibn Ma'in, we know all these a'imma, they did believe that Abu Bakr was superior. They did believe he was a virtuous Muslim, yet they still considered several of these ahadith to be baseless or weak or forged. which we can derive from that these muhaddithun did not allow their theological biases to hinder their objective take on the authenticity of a hadith. Now, that's all I have for everyone today here, inshallah. And if you guys want to know more about this, in the next few days, I will be releasing an essay, a detailed essay on the topic with the brothers at Islamic Discourse Initiative. Please check them out. And it'll be entitled Theology, Orthodoxy, and the Question of Hadith. If you like the video, guys, please like, share, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.